Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today, let me show you how to set a custom alert sound on your Mac. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to more than 1,000 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There, you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So whenever you try to do something on your Mac that isn't allowed, and in a few other situations, you get an alert sound. For instance, here I'm in Contacts and I've selected one of the categories here on the left instead of an actual contact. So if I hit the delete key, I get the alert sound. You can set your alert sound in System Preferences and then go to Sound, then Sound Effects. And here you can select an alert sound and you can go through all of the different built-in system alert sounds and select one. Then you can also select what speaker or headphone or other audio device you've got where the sound should play through and the volume for the sound. But what if you don't want to use one of those? What if you want to take your own sound file and use that as your own custom alert sound on your Mac? Well, to start, let's get an alert sound. So here I've got a sound, just an MP3 file. You could have recorded this yourself. You could have made it in GarageBand or any sound editing app. You could have gotten it from a friend. You could do anything you want to create this sound file. Now we're going to take that and put that into a special location where it will add that sound to the list. But first, it has to be the right type. So here you can see this file is an MP3 file. That won't work. In order for it to be a system alert sound, it needs to be using the file format AIFF, which is the standard lossless Apple Mac format that goes back a couple decades. So when you're creating the sound or converting it in whatever sound app you're using, make sure you export as AIFF and that will work. However, you can trick macOS into thinking any sound is an AIFF file. You see, sound files contain all sorts of different formats and compression types. So no matter how you name it, whether it's MP3, AIFF, M4A, when a Mac goes to play the sound in most cases, it's going to actually look at the format in there and play that sound no matter what's actually in the file. So I'm going to take this MP3 file and I'm just going to rename it using AIFF at the end. And even though I know it's an MP3 file, it will still work. I can click on the icon here and it will play. So now let's put it in the proper place. In the Finder, I'm going to create a new Finder window here and I'm going to go to the Library folder. Now if you look in the Go menu, you'll see the Library folder here. You don't see it? Well, that's because you need to hold down the Option key and the Library folder appears there. You have to hold the Option key down for a library to appear. Select it and now you're in the Library folder. Let's switch to Column view and under Library, look for the folder called Sounds. If you don't see this folder, it's okay to create an empty folder here. Just name it exactly Sounds. Now let's move this file into it. So now in my Sounds file, I've got this AIFF file. So now if I look in System Preferences, go to Sound, under Sound Effects, in addition to the default sounds, there's the one I just added. You see, you can't change the rest of these sounds because they're part of the system and the system is write protected, so it can't be messed with. But in your own library folder, you can add sounds and it turns out that the sound effects look in both the system library sounds folder and your individual user accounts library sounds folder for sounds. That's why this appears here as well as the rest. So test out the sound here and once it's set, you'll find that it works in situations where you do something and the alert sound needs to play. So again, here I'm going to hit delete in contacts without anything selected and I get my own custom sound. Now there is one other place where you can use these system alerts and that's in the Mail app. The Mail app has a special sound that plays when you get a new message. So here in Mail, go to Mail, Preferences, and then go to General and you can see New Messages Sound. And it will be set to New Messages Sound, which is a special sound in the Mail app. But you could also select one of the system sounds. And you can see in this case, all of the default ones are in a set by themselves and then your custom ones are at the bottom. So now that sound will play when you get a new message. And note that you don't have to set this to be the same sound. So you can add several sounds to your library sounds file and then set one to be your system alert sound and another one to be your incoming message sound. Now if you're looking to change other default sounds, well, you'll find that you can't. There's just no setting in macOS for other sounds. For instance, you can't change the sound that plays when you put an item in the trash or empty the trash. In addition, you can't change notification sounds. And notifications are what most apps use when something happens. So for instance, in Reminders here, I have a reminder set to trigger a notification at a specific time. And if I go to System Preferences and then Notifications and then Reminders, I can turn on and off play sound for notifications. But I can't change that notification sound. So we should hear it here in a second. So there it is. That's a special sound and it comes from the Reminders app itself. When an app sets up a notification, it can include a sound. So different apps can include different sounds to play and you can't customize them. You can only choose to not play them if you want. Now there's nothing to prevent an app from actually letting you choose a sound for the notification and that would usually be found in the preferences for that app. But in the case of Reminders, there's no such setting. Third-party apps may be different and in the future Apple may add more options in its built-in apps. So if you're looking to set up custom notification sounds, you're out of luck. That's not related to the system alerts. Now one thing people may want to do is to actually turn off the alerts. And you could do that in System Preferences, Sound. You can simply set the alert volume all the way down. Another thing you could do is you could set it up so that you have a silent sound that plays. So for instance, you can have a silent sound for the Mail app and keep a regular sound for system alerts. To create a silent sound, you can just use QuickTime Player, for instance, create a new audio recording, record nothing, and then when you get the result here, Command T to trim, it's also under Edit, Trim, and then you could trim this down to nothing. Now you've got this empty sound here. If you save, you could save this out as silent.m4a. M4a is not going to work because it's got to be an AIFF, so we'll change that to AIFF. And then you could add that to the library sounds folder here alongside any others that you've added. And now in System Preferences and in Mail, you can set your sound to be your own silent sound. If you set the sound to silent, one thing you may want to do is in System Preferences go into Accessibility and then there under Audio, there's a checkbox here for flash the screen when an alert sound occurs. So you've got a silent alert, but you see the screen flash when an alert actually happens. So it's quiet, but you still are getting some sort of feedback. Hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.